Hello my dear students, in the previous classes we studied about limits and derivatives. So I hope that concept is clear to you. After limits and derivatives, the next topic is mathematical reasoning, but for this year that topic is deleted. So we are going to start our next topic, that is chapter 15, statistics. Statistics you studied in 9th class also, 10th class also, and in 10th class I think you studied in details there. We know in 10th class we studied the measures of central tendency. What are the measures of central tendency? Yes, they are mean, median and mode. Mean, median and mode. So in 10th class in detail we studied how to calculate the mean, median and mode of the given observation. Okay, so now here let me tell you what is the actual meaning of mean or average. Suppose in a class we are getting out of 50, if we are saying average mark is 37, average mark is 37. Actual meaning of average is, if average mark is 37 means the marks of all the students, it is either equal to 37 or nearly 37. Okay, either it will be less than, slightly less than 37 or greater than 37. That is the meaning of average. All the marks, all students' marks lies on this range only. Okay, but actual case it is not there, correct? If average mark is 37 means some students might have got 6 marks, some students might have got 50 marks. So there is a difference in the average there, correct? Deviation, the value deviates from the average. Okay, so how much deviation is there from all these, that we are calculating in this chapter. Okay, how much its value deviates from the mean, that we are going to calculate there. So before calculating that, first we can write down the formulas so that it will be easy for us to calculate. So all of you, first one, normally if some observations are given, how we are calculating the observation. So first we have to calculate the mean. So just write down, first one is mean of n observations. Mean of n observations. So suppose, just write down there, let x1, x2, etc, xn be n observations. How we are calculating the mean? If in this way some numbers are there, yes, sum of all these numbers divided by total number, and we are denoting it by x bar. X bar is equal to x1 plus etc plus xn divided by n. Sum of all the observation divided by total number of observation. This is the mean there. Now what we have to calculate, how much it deviates. Okay, so now we are calculating the deviation from the mean, and also we are taking the average of these deviations. So that is called mean deviation from mean there. Okay, mean deviation from average or mean. Mean deviation about mean also we are saying. Mean deviation about mean or average. How much each value deviates from the mean there. Okay, so deviates means how much difference is there in each value. So already observations are there, and x bar also we have calculated. After that what we will do, we'll calculate the deviation, and to avoid the negative sign we are taking the modulus. So first we will calculate how much each value deviates, differentiate from the mean there. Okay, so first xi minus x bar will give you the difference between the mean and the given value. After that what we have to calculate? Yes, we have to calculate the mean deviation. So mean deviation, as we know, means we are calculating the average there. So for that formula will be equal to mean deviation MD. You can write mean deviation is equal to sigma. Sigma means what we are doing, how much difference we are getting. We'll take the addition of all the differences, then divided by n, total number of observation. So when we will do the question, that time this concept will be more clear to you. At present you can write down the formula. First we will calculate the mean. After that, mean deviation about mean. How we will calculate? we will find the difference between each value and mean. Okay, we'll find out the difference between each value and the mean. We are taking modulus sign, that's why that difference will be positive only. Don't take the negative sign. So whatever the difference is coming, what we will do, we will add all the differences and then we will divide it by n to get the mean deviation. So mean deviation gives the deviation in mean there, how much each value deviates from mean, and then we will calculate the average. So I hope this is clear, this formula. Okay, so this is the case when observations are given. Now the second case, if the observations are repeated, correct, if the observations are repeated, that is mean of grouped data. So write down there, the next heading is mean of grouped data. Mean of grouped data. Sometimes if the observations are repeated so many times, so instead of adding all the observation, we are writing it in terms of frequencies, correct? So if x1, x2, write down there, let x1, x2, etc., xn be n observations, be n observations with frequencies. With frequencies means each observation is repeated that many times. With frequencies f1, f2, etc., fn. In that case, how we are calculating the median? X bar is equal to, yes, sigma fi xi by sigma fi. What we will do? We'll multiply each observation by the corresponding frequency. And whatever multiplication is coming, we are adding all these. And then to get the mean, we are writing sigma fi xi by sigma fi. This is mean. Now what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the mean deviation from mean there. Okay, so mean deviation, MD, you can write down for that. Mean deviation is equal to, again, we got the mean. Now what we will do? We'll calculate the difference. So modulus of xi minus x bar, and since the frequency is there, what we will do, we'll multiply it by corresponding frequency, because to get the mean that only we did there, after that divided by sigma fi. So sigma fi into modulus of xi minus x bar divided by sigma fi. Clear? Okay, so this is the first case when observations are given. After that, in some cases, frequencies are given. Okay, so just write down there, continuous frequency distribution. In case of continuous frequency distribution. Continuous frequency distribution means when class intervals are given. Okay, so when class intervals are given, first formula is same. X bar is equal to sigma fi xi by sigma fi xi. One more method is there to calculate the mean. That was, I think, step deviation method will be easy when we will calculate the mean in continuous frequency distribution. In that case, how we are calculating the mean, that I am writing the formula only. When we will discuss the question, that time we can discuss in detail. X bar is equal to A plus sigma fi ui by sigma fi into h. X bar is equal to A plus sigma fi ui by sigma fi into h, where A is the assumed mean. A is the assumed mean. Ui is equal to di by h. How we are calculating di? Xi minus A by h. What is h there? When we will calculate di, the common factor, the highest common factor of all the di's. So you can write down there, where h is the HCF of all the di's. HCF of all the di's. So using this formula, first we will calculate the mean. After that, what we have to calculate? Yes, we have to calculate the mean deviation. For that, same formula, what we will write? Sigma fi into modulus of xi minus x bar whole divided by sigma fi. So today we are going to discuss about mean deviation about mean only. Two are there. We can calculate the mean deviation from median because median also gives the central value. But today we are going to discuss only about how to calculate the mean deviation about mean. So I hope you all have wrote these formulas. Okay. So when we'll discuss each type of question, so it will be easy for you to identify which formula should be used, and formulas also it will be a revision for you because in 10th class we studied how to calculate the mean there. Only the new thing is mean deviation. Okay. So all of you write down the question. Find the mean deviation about the mean. Find the mean deviation about the mean for the following data. Okay. Find the mean deviation about the mean for the following data. So in that first one write down there. The observations are given 6, 7, 10, 12, 13, 4, 8, 12. Means what is given? Xi. Only observations are given. So it will be easy for us if we will write down the observation in this way, in vertical order. So when you are writing in vertical order, place the number according to their correct places also. So addition, everything we can do here only. Okay, so Xi, it is given 6, 7, 10, 12, 13, 4, 8, 12. So first what we have to do? Yes, we have to add all the observations. So here only we can write what will be sigma fi. Sigma or summation. Summation means addition only. So now just to check how we can add the numbers so that it will be easy for us to do the addition there. What will be 12 plus 8? 20. Okay, so written here 12 plus 8? 20. What will be 13 plus 7? 13 plus 7 also is equal to 20. Now we can check how we can do the addition there. Just to check. 12 plus 4. 12 plus 4 will be equal to 16. 16 plus 6 will be equal to 16 plus 6. 22 plus 10 will be equal to 32. Correct. So just to check here addition. Xi 6, 7. Otherwise, in this way, if it is difficult for you, you can simply add the numbers there. Either you can group the numbers or you can simply add the number. Just to check what will come. 6 plus 7, 13. 13 plus 2, 15. 15 plus 3, 18. 18 plus 4, 22. 22 plus 8. 22 plus 8 will be equal to 30. So 30 plus 2 is equal to 32. Carry over 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. So we are getting sigma xi is equal to 72. Leave some space here because we have to calculate the deviation there. Okay. So I am writing here x bar is equal to, the formula is sum of all the observation divided by total number of observation. Sum of all the observation we got 72 by. Just to check total how many observations are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So divided by 8. So we can cancel here. So we got x bar is equal to 9. So at present we calculated the mean only. Now what we have to calculate? We have to calculate the mean deviation about mean. How much each value deviates, differentiates from the mean. So for that what we will write here? Modulus of xi minus x bar. Modulus of xi minus x bar. This is xi and this is x bar. So first one, 6 minus 9 will be equal to minus 3. But modulus sign is there. That's why modulus of minus 3 is plus 3 only. Okay. Then next one, 7 minus 9 will be equal to minus 2. So I am writing there plus 2. Then 10 minus 9, 1. 12 minus 9, 3. 13 minus 9, 4. Then 4 minus 9 will be equal to minus 5 since modulus sign is there, plus 5. Then 8 minus 9, minus 1, plus 1 only we will write. 12 minus 9, 3. So we got here mean deviation. How much the mean deviates from all the values. Now what we have to do? we have to calculate the mean of these differences. So just add there 3 + 2 = 5 + 1 = 6, 6 + 3 = 9, 9 + 4 = 13, 13 + 5 = 18 + 1 = 19 + 3 = 22. So we got here sigma modulus of xi minus x bar is equal to 22. Now write down there mean deviation is equal to, the formula is sigma modulus of xi minus x bar by n. So it will be equal to 22/8. We can cancel here. It will be equal to 11/4. Now we can divide it, because usually mean we are not writing in fractions there. So mean deviation also we can convert into decimal. So what will come? 4 2s are 8. So 11 - 8 = 3, which is slightly less than which is less than 4. So we'll put a decimal, then it will be equal to 30. So 4 7s are 28, and then 4 5s are 20. So it will be equal to 2.75. So I think it is clear how to calculate the mean deviation about mean. Okay. So now write down the next question. Second one. In second one also observations are given. So just write down there. So many observations are there. 12, 3, 18, 17, 4, 9, 17, 19, 20, 15, 8, 17, 2, 3, 16, 11, 3, 1, 0, 5. So these many observations are there. So first what we have to do? Yes, we have to calculate the addition of all these observations. Sigma xi is equal to, just check here, okay, 12 + 8 = 20, 13 + 7 = 20, 18 + 2 = 20, 20, 16 + 4 = 11 + 9, 17 + 3 = 20, 20 + 0 = 20, 15 + 5 also = 20 there. So how many times we are getting 20 there? Just check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 times we are getting the addition equal to 20. So how we can add? Yes, 20 into 10. So our sigma xi is equal to 200. Okay. So just now calculate the mean there. X bar is equal to, formula is sigma xi by n. How many observations are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 plus 10, 20. So 200/20. 200/20. So we got here our mean is equal to 10. Okay. Mean is equal to 10. Now what we have to calculate? Mean deviation about mean, about average only. So just write down here modulus of xi minus x bar. Since it will not come here, I will write here in two columns, two rows there. Okay. So first one, 12 - 10 will be equal to 2. Then 3 - 10, negative sign not writing. Okay. So 10 - 3 = 7. 18 - 10 = 8. 17 - 10 = 7. Then 10 - 4 = 6. 10 - 9 = 1. 17 - 10 = 7. 19 - 10 = 9. 20 - 10 = 10. 15 - 10 = 5. Then here, 10 - 8 = 2. 17 - 10 = 7. Then 10 - 2 = 8. 10 - 3 = 7. 16 - 10 = 6. 11 - 10 = 1. 10 - 3 = 7. 10 - 1 = 9. 10 - 0 = 10. 10 - 5 = 10. So just to check in this way, if we wrote, now we have to add all these numbers there. So just I can do this addition because these numbers are same. So directly we can write down there. Okay. So just to check the addition now. 7 + 2 = 9. 9 + 8 = 17. 17 + 7 = 24. 24 + 6 = 30. 30 + 1 = 31. 31 + 7 = 38. 38 + 9. 38 + 9 will be equal to 47. 47 + 10 = 57. 57 + 5 57 + 5 = 62. So 62 + 62 will give you 2 + 2 = 4, 6 + 6 = 12, 124. So we got here sigma modulus of xi minus x bar is equal to 124. Now write down there mean deviation is equal to, formula is sigma modulus of xi minus x bar by n, total number of observations. So it is equal to 124/20. So first we can cancel it by 2. So it will be equal to 2 ones are here, 2 6 are, 2 2s are. 62/10 will be equal to 6.2. So I think it is clear how to calculate the mean deviation when observations are given. Okay. So now we'll check the next question. In the next question, related to grouped frequency distribution, when value of xi is given and corresponding frequency is also given. So write down the third question, xi fi. So in place of xi write down 2 5 6 8 10 12, frequencies 2 8 10 7 8 5. Okay, so now just to check here, meaning is the observation 2 is repeated 2 times, 5 is repeated 8 times. So now first we have to calculate the mean. So to calculate the mean, what should be the next column? Yes, it is equal to fi into xi. We have to multiply each observation there. Okay, so 2 2s are 4, 5 8s are 40. So just write down in correct position so that it will be easy for us to do the addition. Okay, then 6 × 10 = 60, 8 7s are 56, 10 × 8 = 80, 12 5s are 60. Okay, so now what are the addition we need? We don't need sigma xi, so don't add this one, this one only we need there. Okay, so first we are calculating what will be sigma fi xi and sigma fi. So just to check what will be sigma fi, 8 + 2 = 10, 10 + 10 = 20, 7 + 8 = 15, 15 + 5 = 20. So 20 + 20 = 40, sigma fi is equal to 40. Now we can do this addition there. Okay, so just to check how much we will get there, how to make the addition easy, that only I am checking. Okay, 56 + 4 will be equal to 60, correct? Now 60 + 60 = 120, 120 + 60 will be equal to, yes, 180, correct? Just to check here, 56 + 4 = 60, so this one done, then 60 + 60 = 120 + 60 is equal to 180. Now 80 + 40 will be equal to, yes, that will be equal to 120. Now we can add, answer will be equal to 300. Okay, so sigma fi xi is equal to 300 we got. Now first what we will do, yes, we calculate the mean. X bar is equal to, formula is sigma fi xi by sigma fi. Sigma fi xi, we got the value is equal to 300/40. 300/40 when we will do, just to check what will come, it will get cancelled. Here we will get there 2 2s are 4, 15. Okay, so 15/2 will be equal to 7.5. But when we will do the calculation, because now we have to do the subtraction there, so in decimal it will be difficult for us to calculate. So if you want, you can write down the approximate value. So 7.5 approximate we can take is equal to 8 there. Okay, so at present we calculated the mean there. Now what we have to do? We have to calculate the mean deviation. So for that, first we need modulus of xi minus x bar. Modulus of xi minus x bar. This is xi. When you are calculating, just put your hand here, because sometimes students will subtract from frequencies there. Xi minus x bar. Our mean we have taken is equal to 8 here. Okay. So 8 minus 2. 6, then 8 minus 5, 3, 8 minus 6, 2, 8 minus 8, 0, 10 minus 8 I am doing because modulus sign is there. That's why negative sign will not come. So why to write that negative there? You just take the positive value only. So 10 minus 8, 2. 12 minus 8, 4. Don't add at present because when frequencies are given, the next column is required. That is Fi into modulus of Xi minus X bar. Again, this is Fi and this is modulus of Xi minus X bar. Now we have to multiply these two. 6 2s are 12. 8 3s are 24. 10 into 2, 20. 7 into 0, 0. 8 2s are 16. 5 4s are 20. Okay, now we need only this addition there. Sigma Fi into modulus of Xi minus X bar. So just to check, we can do the addition here only in this way. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 6, 12. Carry over 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. 7 plus 2 will be equal to 9. So we got the addition is equal to 92. Now write down there, mean deviation is equal to sigma Fi into modulus of Xi minus X bar by sigma Fi, which is equal to 92 by 40. So we can cancel here. Just to check whether 92 is divisible by 4. Divisible? Okay, so we can cancel it by 4. 4 ones are 4, 0 here. 4 twos are 8. 9 minus 8, 1. So 4 threes are 23 by 10 will give you 2.3. So this is mean deviation. Okay. Is it clear? Okay. Now we can check the next question. Next question also same type only so that it will be easy for you to clear the concept. Okay. So in the next one, write down fourth question. Xi. Value of Xi and Fi. Xi is given there 3. 9, 17, 23, 27. 3, 9, 17, 23, 27. Then Fi, 8, 10, 12, 9, 5. 8, 10, 12, 9, 5. Okay, so first what we need? Yes, we need Fi into Xi. So just to do the multiplication there, 3 8s are 24. So 3 8s are 24. Here only you write in correct position there. Okay. 10 into 9, 90. The number in unit place should be in unit place only. Now 17 into 12 we have to do. 17 2s are 34. Carry over 3. 17 1s are 17. Plus 3 will be equal to 20 there. Okay. Then 23 into 9. 9 3s are 27. Carry over 2. 9 2s are 18. 18 plus 2 will be equal to 20. Then 27 into 5. 5 7s are 35. Carry over 3. 5 2s are 10. 10 plus 3, 13. Okay. So now when we wrote the number here in this way, here only we can do the addition. We need here sigma Fi and sigma Fi Xi. So first we can do this addition there. Just to check. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 9, 19. 19 plus 5, 24. Carry over 2. 2 plus 1, 3. Plus 1, 4. So sigma Fi is equal to 44. Now sigma Fi Xi is equal to 4 plus 4, 8. 8 plus 7, 15. 15 plus 5, 20. Carry over 2. 2 plus 2, 4. 9 plus 4, 13. 13 plus 3, 16. Carry over 1. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. So sigma Fi Xi is equal to 660. Now if you want, you can write directly there. X bar is equal to 660 by 44. Divisible by 11. So we can cancel it by 11. 11 6 are 0. 11 4 are. And 60 by 4 will be equal to 15. So X bar is equal to 15. Now what we need? Yes, we need the deviation. Difference in mean and the original value. Our original observation is this. Frequency gives how many times each observation is repeated. So next column here, modulus of xi minus x bar. Just keep your hand here. Okay. This is xi and this is x bar. We have to calculate the difference and modulus sign is there. That's why don't take the negative value. Okay. So 15 minus 3 will be equal to 12. Now 15 minus 9. 15 minus 9 will be equal to 6. Then 15 minus 17. Minus 2 will come. Positive only we can write. That is 2. Now 23 minus 15. 23 minus 15 will be equal to 8. 27 minus 15. So 7 minus 5, 2. So it will be equal to 12 here. That is xi minus x bar. Next we have to multiply with frequency. Fi into modulus of xi minus x bar. This is Fi. Okay. And this is modulus. So 12 8s are 96. 10 into 6, 60. 12 2s are 24. 9 8s are 72. 12 into 5, 60. Now we can do the addition there. Sigma Fi into modulus of xi minus x bar. Just do the addition there. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. Carry over 1. 9 plus 1, 10. 10 plus 6, 16. Plus 2, 18. 18 plus 7 will be equal to 25. 25 plus 6 will be equal to 31. So 312. Now we will calculate the mean deviation. Means what we are doing? We are calculating how much the value differentiate from the mean. And then we are taking the average. That is mean deviation about mean. Okay. So 312 by our sigma Fi is 44. So 312 by 44. First what we can do, just to check, I think it is divisible by 4. So we can cancel it by 4. 4 ones are 4. Here it will be equal to 4. It's a 4 sevens. 4 sevens are 28. So 31 minus 28, 3. So 4 8s are. So when you will divide it by 11, 78 by 11, I think it will give you 7 point something. 11 sevens are 77. 7.01 something will come. So you can write down the answer there. I think it is clear. Okay. Now we'll discuss the next type. Okay. Now, the concept is same. In all the questions, we have to calculate the mean deviation and then we'll calculate the mean deviation. So, just write down there, marks number of students. Marks number of students. So, always when it is given in this way, number means that is frequency. So, here only you can write down this is frequency. Now, write down the class interval 10 to 20. 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80, 80 to 90. And frequencies are given here 8, 10, 15, 25, 20, 18, 9, 5. Now here in previous one xi was given, but in this question xi is not given. Okay, xi is what? Actually xi means the class mark there. Okay, so how we are calculating the class mark? Upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. So 20 plus 10 will be equal to 30. 30 by 2 will be equal to 15. Then 30 plus 20, 50 plus 2 by 2 will be equal to 25. Now you can see the pattern there. How much is the difference there? That will be the values will come there. Okay. 20 minus 10 is 10. So 15 plus 10, 25. So without doing the division, you can write down. Next will be equal to 35, 45, 55, 65, 75, 85. Now in this way, at present, if you will do the calculation, so many big numbers are there. So to avoid this one big calculation, we are using step deviation method. Okay. So formula already I told you. Now we'll check how to do it by step deviation method. In that we wrote one value, that is A. I said A is the assumed mean. Assumed means these are our observation. From this observation, we have to take a middle value there. So just to check, how many observations are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 observations are there. If 8 observations are there, then obviously 2 middle values will come, correct? Now, that is our choice. Which one you want, you can take as the mid value. So, shall I take 45? Okay, so I am writing there A is equal to 45. So, next column, that is DI is equal to XI minus A. Now, we have to do the subtraction. Modulus sign is not there. So, negative values are also possible. Okay, XI is this and A is equal to 45. So, first what we are doing? 15 minus 45. What will be 15 minus 45? Yes, minus 30. Then next, 25 minus 45 will be equal to minus 20. 35 minus 45, minus 10. 45 minus 45, 0. 55 minus 45, 10. 65 minus 45, 20. 75 minus 45, 30. And then it will be equal to 40. DI we have calculated. Still numbers are big there. Now to make it small, we introduced the next, that is UI. And UI is equal to, formula is DI by H. What is H here? Yes, H is the, just check the DI is there. All the DIs are divisible by 2, are divisible by 5. And what is the highest number by which each DI is divisible? Yes, that is equal to 10 there. So we will take here H is equal to 10. And how we will get UI? DI by H. So you have to divide each DI by 10 there. So it will be equal to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we are going to calculate the mean. So again for that we have to calculate FI into UI. Just to check there, this is your FI. FI into UI we have to do. So 8 into minus 3, minus 24. 10 into minus 2 will be equal to minus 20. 15 into minus 1, minus 15. 25 into 0, 0. 20 into 1, 20. 18 into 2, 18 2's is 36. 9 3's are 27. 5 4's are 20. Now we need only this addition, that is sigma fi ui, and then we need sigma fi. So just to check what will be the addition there. Okay, 20 and minus 20 will get cancelled there. Now we can check how we can do the addition there. 27 minus 24 will be equal to 3. Okay. So, 27 minus 24 is equal to 3 we wrote here. What will be 20 minus 15? 20 minus 15 will be equal to plus 5. So, this one also over, remaining is 36 only. Now, we can add there 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 6, 14. So, here it will be equal to 44. Okay, so we got here sigma fi ui is equal to 44. Now we can check what will be sigma fi. Just add the numbers there. 8 plus 5, 13. 13 plus 5, 18. 18 plus 8 will be equal to 26. 26 plus 9 will be equal to, yes, 35. 35 plus 5, 40. Carry over 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Plus 1, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 2, 10. 10 plus 1, 11 there. So we are getting here sigma fi is equal to 110. Now first what we will calculate? Yes, we have to calculate the mean there. So here I am calculating. Okay, x bar is equal to, formula is a plus sigma fi ui by sigma fi into h. We will substitute the values now. A is equal to 45, already we wrote there. Now sigma fi ui is 44. If sigma fi ui is coming negative, no problem there, huh? It can be negative because after that it is added to the assumed mean which we have taken. It can be negative, it can be zero also. So sigma fi ui is 44, sigma fi is 110 into h we have taken is equal to 10. So here this 2 will get cancelled. 11 4s are 44. So 45 plus 4 is equal to 49. So at present we calculated the mean only. Now we have to calculate the mean deviation. Okay. So I think for these all these are not required. So I am just rubbing it. X bar is equal to 49. X bar is equal to 49. Just remember that we need only frequency there. So rest all I am rubbing. Xi we need there because Xi minus X bar we have to calculate. Okay. So Xi I am writing there. I think it was equal to 15, 25, 35, 45, 55, 65, 75, 85. Now first what we need? Yes, we need modulus of xi minus x bar. Now we have to do the subtraction there just to check how much it will come. 49 minus 15. So 9 minus 5, 4, 4 minus 1, 3, 34. Then 49 minus 25 will be equal to 24. 49 minus 35 will be equal to 14. 49 minus 45 will be equal to 4. After that, don't write that will be equal to minus 4 there. What we have to do? 55 minus 49. Correct? 55 minus 49. So it will be equal to 15 minus 9, 6. So it will be equal to 6. Then 65 minus 49 will be equal to 16. 75 minus 49 will be equal to 26, and here it will be equal to 36. Then what we will do? Yes, we'll calculate Fi into modulus of Xi minus X bar. Now again we have to do the addition multiplication there. 8 4s are 32, carry over 3. 8 3s are 24, plus 3 will be equal to 27. 10 into 24 will be equal to 240. Now 15 into 4. 15 4s are 60. Carry over 6. 15 ones are 15. 15 plus 6 will be equal to 21. Then 25 into 4, 100. 20 into 6, 120. 18 into 16 we have to do there. 18 6s are, that is 18 6s are is 108. Carry over 10. 18 ones are 18 plus 10 will be equal to 28. Then 26 into 9. 9 6 are 54. Carry over 5. 9 2s are 18 plus 5, 23. Then 36 into 5. 5 6 are 30. Carry over 3. 5 3s are 15 plus 3, 18. Now I think you can do this addition. What will be sigma? Fi into modulus of xi minus x bar. Just do the addition, and after that to calculate the mean deviation, what you will do? Whatever addition you got here, sigma fi into modulus of xi minus x bar, just divide it by 110. So I hope this method is clear. That method, you seems it is lengthy because we used step deviation method. Then only our calculation become easy there. Because otherwise, if big numbers are there, it will be difficult for you to do the multiplication there. If you are comfortable with usual method, direct method, you can do by that method also. One question I explained so that you should know how to do the question using step deviation method. So I hope all these questions are clear to you. Okay. Now, in some question, if the class interval is not continuous, like in some question, first it will be given 1 to 4, then it will be given 5 to 9. In book it is written, make it continuous there. But when you are calculating the mean, you don't have to make it continuous there. Use the same method what we did, because in calculating the mean, we don't need any lower limit and upper limit. That's why don't make it continuous there. Okay, so I hope these questions are clear. So all of you, write down your homework. Your homework will be equal to exercise 15.1. Mark the question numbers there. Okay. Exercise 15.1. You have to calculate the mean deviation about mean only. So question number 1, 2. After that, question number 5, 6. And then question number question number 9 and 10. Okay, so all these questions are find the mean deviation about mean. Okay, so do these questions, and in case of any doubt, you can ask. Thank you.